Jumping just to from 5th to 4th place, for example, is kind of a big deal in terms of the way Phase 3 is going to play out.
Yeah, definitely. That basically automatically wins you a match.
Yep.
And so we have Ohio on the Tidehunter going on the offlane. We have KYXY on the Tinker, probably being farmed up by... Wait. Let's have a look at this. Yeah, probably. I don't know.
We're waiting. And yeah, it looks like they're...
Is Yamate gonna be... Okay, they're farming Yamate up on the Brewmaster instead.
Okay, that makes a bit more sense. Yep, Yamate on the Brew. He's down here at the moment with Extinct and Net in mid, KYXY, and then Ohio looking to probably take that tight under into the offlane on the other side. See a lot of wards down from LGD. Got a sentry already down in lane, one blocking the pull camp here on the safe side of the Radiant Jungle.
You can see Yao already bought Boots of Speed, which suggests that he's just going straight for the face boots.
And in mid, it's going to be Lin. Yeah, he's going to be solo farming top, it would seem, as Lin is back and ready to block. And this is that aggressive trialing. Rabbit DDC and DD, so isolating the Invoker against what they anticipated to be a... Well, now they've actually got Yamate going top. So, still swapping it out while Net goes ahead and takes a D ward.
And this is why Yao probably went the boots first rather than getting, for instance, a Claws of Attack in case he's going for the Exalt build. Just because you never know if you're actually facing off against a melee hero that is solo or you have to avoid the tri-lane. In this particular case, Yao might actually die just because of the haste on the back of the lion. Sitting back, he does gonna scouting out just now, so he's gonna go back into his tower.
Yep.
That means that Ohio probably won't even be able to stand within creep range.
Board, and now he's got eyes on him, and he got to spin a hex. Nope, just gonna right click some. Not gonna take too many chances. Meanwhile, down
he's going into Quas on the Invoker, so no Sunstrike thus far.
Yeah, we'll have to wait and see where his second and third points end up going. But for now, LGD gonna be dominating this bottom lane. This Tide has got to be very careful. Ohio, having his friendly jungle to work with, really shouldn't have a lot of trouble getting some experience on the Radiant side. But Yamate obviously gonna be free farming on this Brewmaster. How do you like the way the lanes look for both sides?
I think it's very problematic for LGD in the sense that the Tidehunter doesn't desperately need the levels the same way the Invoker does. And the Invoker is a lot easier to pick off.
Yep, it looks like they know that. They're going to go ahead and send DD and DDC. Looping back around, isolating Rabbit up against Tide. Really nice matchup for him. Can always use Feast and or Open Wounds to regen health on Ohio. Big tanky Tidehunter. Nice to chew on. And Net and Extinct are moving right in the exact same direction as DD and DDC, who are under cover of smoke. They actually head north, while these two head south, looking to pre-rune as a pair. And this is going to give them a chance to maybe punish Yamate, who is right up under the tower. Rune is yet to spawn. Going to be 4 seconds until it's there. In the meantime, DD and DDC are closing in.
See the middle lane. Lin is sort of dominating KYXY on the Tinker so far. It's already got 7 denies up on him.
Wow. Yao's taking so much damage. Got crit and then clapped, and now they're going to go. And waiting for him to get off by himself. There's going to be a Soul Catcher to follow and a Rage Fire Blast. So actually, he's not level 2. My bad. I thought he was level 2. But Yamate can't do much. He's going to chase Yao. And Yao pulling back and now going to spin that clap on DD. Not going to matter, as one more auto attack will do it. First blood drawn by DDC.
Great rotation coming out from LGD, and I think the supports on Titan side of things right now are regretting the fact that they just went to top room without doing anything and anything at all.
Well, they stood around there a long time too, man. As much as they went there, like the rune spawned a long time ago as a DD at bottom and no one's even snagged yet.
Tinker picking up the farm though. He was falling a bit behind Lin on the Viper, but because Lin had to fall back and be a bit defensive, that meant that Tinker could finally get some assets. But down on the bottom lane, Lifesteal up against the Tidehunter. Lifesteal is gonna go for the DD rune. 14 CS on him, so he's still leading it ahead of the Panda. We see a rotation coming out from the Titan, smoked up in the Dire jungle.
Looking for a target. Got two, DDC and DD right in front of him. And these two are just gonna pull on back. Knowing something is amiss.
I don't know if LGD is being incredibly lucky or is reading the game perfectly.
I mean, they've been gone for a while. They disappeared, and I think it's a little bit of both. Yeah, no, never mind. I think they were lucky because now they're smoked and heading towards bottom. So their gank timing just very similar to that which Titan wanted to hit. Titans comes up without a whole lot to show for it. We'll see if LGDs can come up aces.
Yeah, and just see how much space that was created for KYXY on the mid lane. He was falling behind in CS and now he's doubling that of Lin just because of how defensively Lin had to play.
Ohio. Horrible position. There's the Sunstrike right on the money. And the follow-up, Raid Fire Blast, Rabbit's right there, has 1 point in open wounds. We'll go ahead and spin it just to secure the kill for sure. And Illusion Root spawns just in the north of everyone at once, and yeah, taking their time. Rabbit's staying right on his tail. And there's going to be an Anchor Smash, and wow, Ohio is going to get under his own tower, and Rabbit has to turn around.
Wow, that level 2 Kraken Shield combined with the Anchor Smash
so
that
strong.
Reduces their damage, so tanky.
Yeah, just... so strong, man. Level 2 Kraken Shell is actually a little bit better than a Stout Shield, so...
Oh, Yao's gonna be careful on top now. Ned is getting in position. He's only level 2, but Yao has no means to escape. He maxed out his Exort now. We saw that Sunstrike go into fake. Didn't really deal a whole lot of damage to the Tidehunter. He could bank his face boobs if he wanted to. I'm not sure why he's waiting.
Nice.
Of course, couldn't know that the supports are about to break in on him, but if I was him, I would bank the face boots and a TP scroll right now.
Yao makes his way into the woods and has no TP. Nowhere to go.
Oh, Titan had to back off because
Radiant's
of the creep wave.
Bottom tower
yep.
is under attack.
The creep, it was a little mistimed there. The creep wave for LGD arrived a little quicker than they would have liked, and like you said, it got chewed through. In the meantime, back towards mid, DDC and DD not done doing their work. Moving now towards mid lane. I'm actually going to head back. And Ohio is going to be moving in their general direction. They were looking for him, and he's just now heading over to do what they thought he was going to be doing, which is messing around in the jungle. Actually, he might catch up to him. They're still hanging out in mid here. Yeah, he's going to spot him. Yep, he sees him. There it is, immediately pinged out. And he's like, yeah, the hell with this. He bails out, as does the Tinker, who's kind of playing defensively, though a bit forward. Either way, DD and DDC can't find anything.
Yeah, I think KYXY is thanking him right now.
Yep.
He was like, oh, that's where they were. Oh, okay.
Well, it's 6 minutes in. The Tinker doing quite well for himself. 24 CS, not as well as the Lifestealer, but he is now completely left alone. So that's
Radiant's
to be expected. Already has his phase up. Now he's
going
to go ahead and finish his Magic Wand. What do you think is going to be coming up next for him?
I think he might just go for a Midas.
Yeah?
I don't think a hand of Midas... Oh, okay. And as I say that, he's completing up his Magic Wand and, of course, a Bracer. So he may just go straight into Drums instead of at all going for a Midas. On top, though, Yao still not having bought anything. Is he going for face boost right now or is he getting greedy and getting a Midas? He's standing close to the side shop. He's trying Power Threads. Okay, so a bit of tankability for him rather than move speed and farm capability. Okay.
And Ohio has gone back in the lane now, and eating some CS and some experience right up under his own tower. Not about Anchor Smashing, there you go. So he's getting a decent amount of gold up top, though we've got an engagement, as Yamatank, not yet level 6, ends up dropping, as Yao, DD, and DDC engage, and send Net running for it.
Quick change of spell from Yao as well. He actually managed to use the Cold Snap and invoke into both Sunstrike and Chaos Meteor. He didn't even have to use the Sunstrike, though.
DD and DDC continuing to just rain terror.
Soul Catcher combo is so lethal.
Oh, DDC, you better get out of that, buddy. That hurts a lot. Ate about a third of his health bar walking in the March of the Machines for every bit of 3 or 4 seconds. Gonna double back now.
I mean, KYXY, haven't gone for the Soul Ring, haven't gone for the bottle. He's just going straight for the Boots of Travel.
Looks like Titan. Not going to be caught unawares, they've got wards all over the place.
Lin closing off with that mechanism, he's going to have an 8 or 9 minute mechanism. And Rabbit, of course, in the bottom lane. Continuing to farm.
Now, how they put this lifesteal to work is going to be the interesting question. Obviously, he does well against all of the magic abilities that Titan has in the early and in the mid game. But it's still the challenge, one of the reasons the hero has fallen off, is it can be tough to get him into a fight and maximize his potential. I mean, they do have the Viper on their own team, which is going to help out immensely. And KYXY is actually eating a lot of damage here, has to use the laser just to keep himself alive.
I would not want to be in Extinct and Net's shoes soon, because if this Lifestealer is going for like a race car build, he's just gonna run them down. You can see he already is close to maxing rage, he only has one skill in Feast, and so with open wounds he can easily catch up to them and take them down in a matter of seconds. And there's nothing they can do about it.
Like like I was saying, with having the Viper and having abilities like Radiant's Cold Snap, Demonic Purge, even the slow from Wraith Fire Blast, how in the world are you going to outrun him? Like, he honestly doesn't even have to go race car. Like, he's going to have plenty of help to allow him to get on targets and stick on targets. Yamate's got a double damage. Rabbit dancing around here and decides to go ahead and back off. Not the best situation for him to be in. Tide's just about level 6, and Yamate just hit level 6, so LGD needs to be careful. This is where Titan's lineup really begins to come into its own.
But Yao is doing a great job on top farming off. He's got those pouches. He's sitting on 1,500 gold, and he didn't have an easy lane by any means to begin with.
And trying to bait out the rage from Rabbit. Trying to fake him out with the clap. There's the mech done, as you said, 9 minutes almost on the money for Lin, while the rest of his team decides to go ahead and start pushing the tier 1 top. Boots of Travel done on the Tinker in the meantime as well, though. And there's going to be a glyph used. Do you think they can defend? Yep, they're going to TP1, and it's going to be Yamate. Yeah, he's going to split right off. And I'm not sure they're going to get anything here. They're going to rock.
I think they can turn on this.
Yeah, they're going to rock DD, and they managed to catch the Shadow Demon, but...
And that's a waste of Brewmaster ulti.
That's actually kind of a big deal.
That leaves a lot of space for LGD now.
Yeah, that's really kind of a big deal.
They do have the Marts to defend with, though. With the Booster Travel up on the Tinker, it's going to be incredibly hard to push in on towers. He has maxed Marts of the machines. So even with the Mechanism up on Lin, I don't think they can actually push down any of these towers just yet. See how fast Yao's HP is dropping.
Just gonna smoke and maybe try to dive behind the tower now.
While all this is going on though, Lifesteal on the bottom lane completing his Drum of Endurance and just continuing to take the lead on the CS board.
DD and DDC. Looking to dive now. There's a march. KYXY spotted. There's going to be Disruption. DD's right there. Sunstrike. Some of that damage split with Net. Net's going to be on the receiving end of the Race Fire Blast. And the meatball dropped right onto Ohio. However, the Ravage caught three. And now Lin and DD both in some trouble. They will be able to get Ohio, but Net right back up off the buyback. Tinker's there to finish one off with a laser. And the other gets away.
Net actually bought back on a level 4 Lion and TP'd back into the fray without getting anything out of it.
Yep.
He did get some experience gain on the Dying Viper though, so that was desperately needed for him. On the support, I mean, on one hand it doesn't mean too much that you buy back this early on. On the other, you really want to put every single cent to use.
For now, everything stabilizing just a bit.
Midas almost completing on Yao.
Yep, so that already has the recipe. And yeah, one more CS and one more CS for 10 seconds, whichever you want to pick. And I'll have that done. But 4-1, LGD leading. All towers still standing on both sides, so let's take a look at pure efficiency and kills. And yeah, it's about what you would expect, I think, just given the way this game has gone. LGD is opening up a bit of a gap in gold and experience.
Yeah, definitely in control. The only one that Titan really have to look to is the Tinker, and then eventually when the AA hits level 6, maybe get some pick-offs around the map. Rabbit on the bottom lane now, it's gonna take down that tower. I don't think there's anything that Titan can do about it. 5 seconds cooldown on the Brewmaster ultimate, but there's no Ravage. For another 70.
Bottom tower has fallen.
A bit cleaning up, and Yao getting some space to continue farming. Just completes his Midas, and we'll be able to move forward and put it to use sometime soon. Abana might have a gank attempt on Yamate. He's got his ulti though. I don't think they can do this. They don't have any.
He'll need to commit to it.
Yeah. It's going to be the Sunstrike, and yeah.
Soulcatcher unfortunately a bit off, hitting the creep instead, and that's the ultimate. That's going to be the death of DDC.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like, I don't know why they tried that. Like, they had to know his ultimate was off cooldown. It was well off cooldown. He had used it a long time ago. Yeah,
Still alive.
Yep, still.
Not alive.
Maybe the plan was to get him to rotate. If that's the plan, then here they come. Here comes Ohio. And now Net's there. Rabbit's trying to go to work and wants to bring down Yamate. Nope, never mind. Thinks better of it, seeing the Tinker decides he wants to run. Not level 6.
He's coming in. He's got the mechas.
Yep, mechs up, but DD still dies nonetheless. Net's just going to TP away, as is Ohio. They have no way to stop them from this. And that really is just one of the more bizarre engagements I've seen in a long, long time. Yamate has TPs, and we'll go ahead and head out.
Drums being put to use. Lin's going to get off that one attack there. It is Boots of Travel move speed, and he is going to get away.
Yep, let's see.
Or is he? Open Wounds, level 3.
There it is. Disruption. And now he's in trouble. So, good guesswork by DDC.
So it ends up actually being LGD winning this match, as they lost 2 supports, but got a Tinker.
And they forced out a Brewmaster ulti. That was just bizarre, though. I mean, they engaged, and there's no way they didn't know that was off.
Oh, yeah, they definitely paid the ultimate price for that game.
Well, Invoker takes a tier one top two. I think that really is just space created. Like, they just went in. They just went in and said, "Hell with it. Let's see what happens."
Yeah, he's really picking up the pace on his farm now. Sitting on another 1,000 gold.
Another disruption.
On the pendant.
Oh, that Sunstrike, just devastating. As Extinct is swiped down by the Lifestealer after the Sunstrike connects for about 4/5 of his health. And now LGD looking to put this early lead to good use, doubling up Titan and kills and ready to assault the tier 1. Ravage is up though, so they need to be careful.
It's interesting to see that DDC has been in 5 kills so far, yet he's only level 4.
That is kind of weird. I should mention it. As if he hasn't been involved. There's the mech and Yamate gonna hit with open points. There's Ohio though. He's got the Ravage.
Tinker denies the tower.
He's hanging on to it. He's playing patiently. He could catch 4 right now if he wanted to. And it looks like they just don't want to take the fight.
Yeah, but look on the top lane. Now those 4 spears are starting to dish out a lot of damage, and Yao is just pushing on that tower.
Why didn't they want to fight there? That was a guaranteed 4-man Ravage. Guaranteed. Like, I'm asking you, like, not to be smart.
I think
it's
because of the nighttime. Ohio had limited vision. He couldn't really tell whether or not he would catch them or not. Oh. And I actually don't think it would have landed on 1 or 2 of them.
Well, I mean, he had
one of them being the Oregon. This was pre-level 6 though, so wouldn't be the worst thing in the world.
I think he could have gotten at least 3. Range on Ravage is just massive.
So DD playing the Lurk the same way we've seen PPD do it, with waiting to skill the reincarnation until he knows that he's not being picked off, but rather can put it to use within a team fight.
Exactly, because right now they're just now entering full 5-man team fight mode.
So keep this in mind, people, when you're playing a support Lurk.
Not always worthwhile to go with the... And for those who are wondering what we're talking about, we cast it earlier, we talked it over, and Melk had the great insight that PPD skipped Reincarnated 6 just because he was roaming and teamfighting hadn't began, and it was just going to be more worthwhile to him to get the extra point in the Hellfire Blast.
To be fair, it did take me some time to figure it out.
It's
one of those things, if you're not actively on a competitive team and you don't talk to anyone about it but have to figure out everything on your own, then you're sometimes going to miss out on some important information going on in the metagame.
A.K.A. me.
And myself.
LGD in very nice control of this game now. Extinct is level 6 now, so they do have Ice Blast. That'll be a nice little coup for them. And help them deal with the early mechanism from Lin, if he's able to land a good Ice Blast at the very least. They're going to smoke Titan, and we'll see if they're able to catch anyone. They have a few targets in range. Head on up towards Roche. And better of it now, doubling back.
Yao closing his Necromicon 1. Tinker putting up his Blink Dagger. Slow item progression, yet Lin can now afford a mid lane.
No mech for you, Lin. Sorry, buddy. Down it goes. That's a really nice game for Titan, especially if they can get the tower out of it.
It's probably gonna mean the tower. They have that Ravage still, and now the split is back up. There's a Blink Dagger on Yamate, and of course, in KYXY, you can lay down. Oh, wait a minute. Red King is TPing in.
Yeah, Red King is level 7 and does have his ulti. Now there's going to be another Sunstrike, and in comes KYXY.
Look at that Mars. Look at how much damage it's doing. And then Panda's gonna pick up the knife.
That slowed him down, though. He's gonna come back up and turn right around onto Net. Behind that, Panda is diving. We can see he's actually tossed one, and Yao's going toe to toe with him. There's going to be a TP in, and DD's just selling out. Really wants that kill, but he's caught, and the greed gets the better of him, and DDC is barely able to survive on the other side. So LGD ends up losing a total of 3 through all that, while Titan loses only 1, their Brewmaster.
Why did Extinct send his ultimate? He could have gotten DDC. Anyways, in that fight, what happened was that Lifestealer desperately wanted to kill the Brewmaster, but he was standing in the midst of 2 marches and lost his HP so dangerously fast that the Brewmaster ultimate could just pick him off by the end of it. Oh, sorry, not the Brewmaster. He was trying to kill the Tidehunter, of course.
Right.
But then the Kraken Shell played in and he could just run away. That was actually a mechanism completed on the Tidehunter, so... Titan getting back into the game now.
How do you feel about them skipping the blink, right, Paul? I mean, I guess the Lion's so poor, it'd be tough to try to get it up on him and Ancient Apparition. I don't know, Ancient Apparition got 1600 gold.
He's just gonna build, maybe he's gonna build a Midas, but other than that, he's just gonna build into that Scepter. And once he gets that, it's one of the most lethal late game support heroes.
Up, they're gonna run right up. Go into Rabbit. Rabbit immediately rages into Hex on the DD, and they're gonna go ahead and engage on this. They're not gonna have the ultimates. They do have Ravage, however. DD doing his job, doesn't have reincarnate up. Behind that, we see Yao going to work on KYXY and vice versa. Lin now isolated out, Cold Feet Proc, not there, does manage to make it out of range, however. That March of the Machine's devastating.
Oh,
we see the buyback.
Off of Ohio.
Yep, DD has bought back and is coming back into it. There's Illusion Rune over to the side. And Yamate gonna grab that, trying to clog things up with the illusions, however. The tide does end up dropping nonetheless, so that's gonna be 2-for-1. Buyback included for DD though, so one little hope he had for Ride of Progression is stunted quite a bit. And they're gonna move into Roche off of this.
After that last fight, Rabbit probably realized that just because you're a life stealer with a decent amount of farm and max level of rage, you're not invulnerable by any means. And with Tide still having Rabbits up, once rage would wear off, Rabbit would have died afterwards. Yeah. So he tried to move in and out of the fight. I think he could have killed off the Lion in a fairly quick manner, the same way Lin did. Didn't actually manned up.
LGD? Getting the Roshan and the Aegis. Is an SNY build, by the way, on the Lifestealer, so pure race car, vroom vroom.
Yeah, and Radiant's top tower. I'm now completing a Necronomicon 2. So definitely getting ahead in terms of items. Point booster up on the Ancient Apparition.
Oh, we're 20 minutes in. How do you feel about the way things have gone for each team? Who do you think? I mean, we can look at the metrics and see, obviously, LGD, but do you think Titan still has a chance to just kind of grind their way back into it, or are they going to have to reach deep and go a little further to get them things back to even?
They definitely have a chance just because they have the better 5-on-5, so these team fights can easily go their way in a very, very quick manner. The thing about this is they only really have the Tinker to rely on for the late game, and he hasn't got the best farm in the world. He's not that far down in terms of the CS board, but there's still no Dagon on him, and we're 20 minutes into the game, he's really, really close to it, but it's by no means incredible.
And in DDC, holding the line by themselves, March is still just crippling at this point.
Rabbits is still up in Ohio.
Here we go, they're going to engage in. Oh, and X in some trouble, extinct. Nope, no, he is finished off by the Infest. So now Lin and company charging back out. Not gonna have Ice Blast. Nelson, and there's going to be Ohio with the Rabbit. He got four. Didn't get DD, but got everyone else. And one immediately blown up by the finger. Rabbit going to work on net. Can he get in? No, he can't. Rabbit's rage gonna wear off sometime very, very soon. Behind that, we see the Brewmaster ulti trying to deal with DD and Yao. Now they're gonna go ahead and retreat. It's just the Earth Panda left. KYXY doing what damage he can using rocket spam and lasers, but Rabbit catches back up to him. Has the Anchor Smash reduce his damage, didn't have rage available either. So LGD sends them packing. They end up trading two away though after they drop the Ancient Apparition and unable to really capitalize on that.
What LGD can do now, however, is push down a tier 2 tower. They know the cooldowns from Titan is on. There's 100 seconds on the Rabbits. 80 on the primal split. LGD doesn't have anything that they need to rely on, and I think you can be absolutely sure that Rabbit is gonna go for a Cranium Basher now. Mm-hmm. Two heroes just TP'd out under his nose, and he just doesn't have the support to go in and disable them for him.
Or dead. Even the mech, oh, actually he backed off. I thought he was going to for sure at least take one more swipe. He's got enough movement speed and an Aegis. They probably could have afforded to maybe risk it, but...
Yeah, probably not worth it for a level 8 support. A bit unfortunate that Yao's Sunstrike hit on the wrong side of him.
Yep. Taking a look at overall net worth. You can see Invoker's atop the board, followed by the Tinker, but after that, it's still more friendly faces for LGD, and then it's a pretty big fall off. The Lifestealer, Invoker, and Tinker all in the same range, then a big fall off of about 3k gold down to the next highest, which is Lin on the Viper and the Brewmaster as well, right around 6200 to 6500.
Yeah, and KYXY now has that Dagon up on the Tinker, so if you're Shadow Demon played by DDC, this game is no fun anymore. even the supports from Titan is gonna really make it a hard game for you. Lion, of course, probably being able to just burst him down on his own, and then the AA ultimate as well. There's not a lot of whole fun things to do for the Shadow Demon in this case.
Babbitt's up here by his lonesome. Titan has extinct and net, keeping a watchful eye on his farming patterns. We'll see if they want to try to do anything cube with it. And KYXY was actually being pursued by, I just noticed that, he was just actually being pursued by some very angry necro creeps and almost died to him.
Rabbit alone in the top lane, both supports from Titan. Burying in the woods. There's no real support, so they're just effectively wasting a lot of time. Imagine if he found one of them.
Yeah, it's like kind of curious too, like even Ohio's hanging far back here.
Ned's now TPing back out.
X isn't. Extinct is happy to be where he is, ready to launch that ulti wherever needed.
Ned is getting fairly close to a blink dagger. You can see he's all he's got is a magic wand and a set of brown boots.
A blink dagger bought up on DD. Nice initiation tool for him. To be another quiet little period in this game. 9 to 10, LGD. Being in gold by around 10k, and the experience right around 5.
And I don't think it's not that LGD doesn't want to fight, it's more that they don't need to fight.
Exactly.
They do have the Aegis of the Mortal, which is going to expire fairly soon, but yeah, in 1 minute as we see now, but there's just no real reason for them to fight. They have the better late game.
Now, Rabbit's coming up on that Basher, as you had mentioned, if that is his choice. He only needs a couple hundred more gold to snag it. Another nice tool to deal with and lock down some of these heroes. Scepter. Unless it's all on the courier, is actually a long ways in coming for Brewmaster. Yeah, he's only got the point booster and a gem, so that scepter going to be quite late.
And now the Wraith King with the Blink Dagger gives new meaning to the Lifestealer Bomb.
Jeez.
Oh, and Tinker's coming in. Wow. Let's see if they can... Nope, he canceled it.
Wow, is he just that smart? He just knows that well?
He watched the creep aura, I think. So the creeps gained the aura from both the drum inside the ice and the
Wind Creep. Oh, that's so smart. That is so smart. How smart? So smart?
So smart.
How about freaking smart? Have a checkbox, please. Titan. Continuing to, for the moment, really outmaneuver LGD. LGD are the ones who are looking to put on a lot of pressure, but Titan, for the most part, is staying safe. Do you feel like they're getting enough efficiency in terms of gold gain on their supports, though?
No, the problem for Titan right now is while they're avoiding ganks and deaths, they're not really getting any farm on anyone but the Tinker, and it's not by any means amazing farm for him either. So he's got a big one, sitting on 1800 gold, so he can afford a Ghost Scepter, which is going to help him a lot against the Lifestealer. But Yamato Dyer's is sitting on a point booster and bought up a Gem of True Sight. I'm not even sure he bought it up. Did he? Probably did, actually. No. Oh, it seems as if Extinct bought it on the Ancient Aberration. But aside from that, he's sitting on 400 gold. He's not really closing up on any, neither Scepter nor BKB or Shivas for that matter. And the same way with Ohio, but he does have those basic items, the Blink Dagger and the Mechanism on the Tidehunter. And that's really all he needs to fulfill his role. Lindo, getting closer to his Scepter.
That Ohio.
I think Lin would be wise to go for a Black King Bow over the Scepter at this point, though.
Gone. There's going to be a Blink out on the Invoker. A lot of targets are hanging around right now. Lin, just to the north, and they've actually... Yep, there's going to be an AOLT. Yep, flies into it. Now they're going to go. As soon as it connects, there's a Ravage Spit on just the one. Figure of Death is there as well. Still took a lot. Now let's see if they want to try to respond to this. They catch Ned from behind. It's a for sure kill, even with the mech. DD's right there as well. He actually eats the Hex. Now it's going to be on Rabbit to try to catch one more. DDC is there and unable to suss out the Tinker before he can escape. So they end up trading the Lion for the Viper, and that's a trade we'll take any day.
That is a lot of hate to commit to one hero, and you can see how tanky that Viper is to begin with. Now that they don't have Ravage, though... Okay, Necromicon is down, so it's going to make it a bit harder to push that tower, but not having Ravage in these teamfights is going to make things a lot easier for LGD when pushing. There is still Primal Spread, and of course the best anti-push in the game through that much of the machine span. And LGD is just going to go back and back off, I think.
Tough to fight into.
It's just not worth the risk, basically.
Yep.
You're gonna take this ancient spot that was kindly stacked by Titan.
just a couple of stacks, not the end of the world. But yeah, I'm actually impressed with how well Titan is. I mean, we've talked about they're not really getting as much gain as you would normally like to see, anything like that.
The problem with this is they're not really fulfilling any objectives. They haven't touched the tower yet. I mean, they've touched them, but they haven't taken them down.
Clearly.
And this is not really a game they want to drag out.
Right. That's kind of what I was saying. They're actually like... I'll say it this way. Tactically, they're doing great. Strategically, they're really not.
Yeah.
If that makes sense. They could end up winning or more, I guess in this case, dodging the battles. Or they're kind of playing guerrilla style, actually. That's probably the most apt way to put it.
With a lineup that isn't really too good. I mean, they have the AA and the Tinker, so in a sense, sure it is. But they also have the Tidehunter and the Brewmaster that sort of requires that you go into a full-fledged 5-on-5.
Right.
So at this point, they're really just delaying the inevitable. Maybe if they played a less skilled team, they could get away with playing like this, but we're talking about LGD.
Exactly.
One of the most experienced teams in the world.
Yep.
This isn't gonna work.
And, you know, it's... I feel like everyone mentally wrote them off after day one. But now, coming into the day, they're right on the cusp of making the comeback a real thing. There's the rock, rolls uphill.
Yao picking up a blink back on his invoker as well.
Yep. Picked that up a while ago.
Oh, Lin actually went for a Hood of Defiance, and he's gonna build into a pipe, and I actually like this choice a lot, because whenever LGD wants to push down these tier 2 towers and try to get their objectives done, they can't just because of the Martin machine.
Smoke pop! DD, with that invis, or I didn't see if it was in. Oh wow, he actually, oh no, okay, I heard him. Heard him yell, but I guess he canceled the animation just in time. He actually finished the entire audio of the split that time. But there's also a blink now up on the lion, by the way. So his lethality has increased quite a bit. But it looks like both teams are just going to go ahead and pull back for now.
They did get that top tower now. Actually, it was denied by the lifestealer, so only 100 gold into the province of each of the Titan members. Roshan being taken for the second time around by LGD.
Hey, ulti. Let's connect. See if they can do something with it.
In terms of Rabbit, I'm a bit torn on whether he should build into an Assault Caress or finish his Abyssal Blade. It's a lot of damage coming out with the Abyssal Blade, and he can keep the Panda or the Broom or the Titan in place for a long, long time. On the other hand, the Assault Curse is just so very good for all purposes, tanking and taking down the targets in a much faster pace. Amate does have to blink up, can easily escape that great thing.
Both big ulties are up, all three if you count Nets. Four just now coming off or extinct, so they're able to fight around their ultimates. It's going to be in. Oh, now they're going to go on Lin. Oh, it's actually caught here. There's going to be a Rabbit to follow, and it got two more. So they get Lin, they also get DD and DDC. Here comes Rabbit going to work on Net. There's the invoker coming in from it as well. And Rabbit just chopping away on these pandas. Now down to the last one. I think that was the last one. They actually get one away.
Yeah, it's running up to the top.
Oh
with
wow!
The spirit.
Yep, there it is. I thought he actually got both of them there, but they end up going one for one once again, trading the lion for the viper.
So with how few team fights there is, Titan don't seem to mind that they invest literally everything they got into taking down Lin on the viper. He even had a Hood of Defiance this time around. You could just see how much damage he soaked up.
Yep.
Finger of Death was used, Ravage was used, Brewmaster ulti was used, and then Tinker. Everything was used on him. I'm not gonna say he almost survived, but it wasn't really a convincing takedown by any means.
Well, you blew everything you have, and now you've got four that are running at your tower, and you have nothing to fight with.
Yeah, but I think that's how desperate Titan is at this point. They're just probably trying to buy time. See, Tinker's actually completing his Dagon 5 before going for the EB. It's a bit unusual. Actually, no, he doesn't. He creates the level 3 Dagon, and now bought the Ghost Scepter, and will probably save for the Eaglehorn.
DD perched on the ridge line here, and yep, they know he's there. AA throws up the ice vortex, and they don't have a rune or anything. I'm not sure how they were a ward. I'm not sure how they would have seen him, but they just good game sense either way. They suspected it, and now they're just going to go ahead and take the tier 2 tower for free. So all the tier 1s except one gone for LGD. Titan in the meantime is down to their last two outer tier towers.
I don't even know, how did LGD get this ward up? When did this happen?
Which one? That
this one?
This one. Not long ago.
Okay.
I didn't see it happen, I just noticed it was there whenever they had Rabbit and DD up there.
Rabbit is probably not the hero they want to run into at this point.
No.
They're probably hoping for a support.
Hey, Rabbit doing his business. And yeah, looks like they are very close to maybe deciding to engage. However, now they're going to see Yao's there now. So DDC. And everyone grouped down. Now they're just going to push here, I think. And they just don't care that much about the marching machines anymore. It's going to force out a glyph. And Tidehunter doesn't have Rabbit, and there it is, he's gonna go in and catch a bunch! Lin and Rabbit both caught with that, defensive disruption keeps him alive. Rabbit, though, has that Aegis, will be coming back up off of that. There's gonna be the Air Spirit tossing the Shadow Demon into the air. Titan trying desperately to extend this game, but with Rabbit back up, Ohio has to run for the fountain, and KYXY, Ghost Scepter or not, will be finished off. That's a 3-4 Aegis. All they managed to get out of that, and I think that might finally be the straw that breaks the camel's back.
And Lin actually lived through it this time around. Yeah. Great disruption coming out from DDC, and this is exactly what LGD's lineup was all about from the get-go. They picked the Viper and the Wraith King, and ultimately the Lifesteal as well, just to live through the combo of Titan. And you saw just how much damage the Viper can endure, especially now that he has the Hood of Defiance, and he's gonna finish off the Pipe of Insight now so that he can actually help his team as well against both Master of the Machines and the AA ultimate.
I want to talk a minute about DDC and his performance. He's 6-2-5, has been involved in 11 of the 15 kills, just now hit level 11, but he has... He's not just been involved, but he's done what, you know, every support should strive to do. He's getting kills is nice, but staying alive is even better. And he has died very few times. Only a handful of heroes on the map have died less than he has. Yao, in the meantime, on his way to a Hex, is going to be able to pick up his Mystic Staff as we speak. And we'll have up the full Hex in just a minute or two. He's actually going to bypass it now, but he could buy it, just so you know.
And the tankers we've been seeing today just don't seem as lethal as they used to.
No, they really don't.
I mean, participating in 6 kills in 34 minutes isn't really a whole lot. And it was the same thing with Dendi's Tinker against, I believe it was DK.
Yep.
Granted, DK did an excellent job at shutting him down, most noteworthy through Lanim's Nyx Assassin play.
MKB done on Rabbit, by the way. So he's going to be hitting so hard.
Not saving at all for buyback or anything.
No, I don't think he's worried about it.
I like that, just investing fully. Yao almost completing a Scythe of Ice. The item progression on LGD is just amazing.
Yeah, I think LGD has an accurate gauge.
Even DD on the Wraith King is closing in on the Black King bar.
I think LGD has a very accurate gauge of how far ahead they actually are. Sometimes you see it that teams don't really know how far ahead they are, they just know they're ahead. I think all of LGD knows, and knows they can afford.
Ooh, this is dangerous. Titan didn't see them smoke up, and they see Titan the entire way. This is game.
Yep, there you go. DD comes in. Yamate blown up before he can even get off the ulti. He's down for a minute, and immediately chopped down is that poor Lion. Rabbit on a dominating streak, and neither the Brew nor the Lion have buyback, so they're going to go ahead and rush to Tier 3.
Was that demonic person one hit from the lifesteal?
Yep. One, you know. Gonna have to march uphill and march with machines, but I really don't think they mind. Rabbit. Doesn't have an Aegis this time, but just look at how quickly he chops down this tier 3 tower. Ice Blast. Pipe is up. Yep, will connect, but like you said, Pipe is up. DD, not super concerned about it all. They should be able to get at least a tier 3. They played super safe, they may have to fall back after this. And they will. Just pushing into March, so difficult, and going for the kill on DD, but earned charge there from a helping hand from DDC.
And looks like LGD is just gonna go back, not use the Aegis just yet. Oh, they didn't have the Aegis, that's why.
Yep.
Roshan is spawning soon.
Dire's
soon-ish.
Top tower is under attack.
Yeah, so there's definitely no reason for them to overextend. I thought Lifesteal had an Aegis on him. I don't even know why I thought that.
Yep, he lost it down
the bottom. Gonna go in and deny the bottom tower. Dire's
bottom tower has been denied.
There you go. Rabbit. Doing his job. And wow, a lot of farm there and one big infest. 2100 gold. He can just go straight to Assault Cuirass now. Go buy his Hyperstone right now. Sell his wand, buy Hyperstone. GG.
He could, but I think he'd be wise to just save for buyback until the Aegis at least.
Yeah, there's the Aegis as well.
Especially because if Titan commits everything and do manage to get him down, if he just buys back and run down the middle lane, there's nothing they can do about it.
For now, holding on to that Cheddar.
Scepter completed on Yamate.
Gonna be a Scepter up on Lin as well. He's got his point booster, his Ogre Club, guess he could decide BKB if he really wants one, but I don't think he did.
You gotta wonder if Ned had preferred going a Ghost Scepter rather than his Blink Dagger right now.
Yep.
The amount of times that Lifesteal has just gone for him, probably 10 times this game.
Well, he's the reason that LGD is able to trade, basically. They go in, they blow everything to kill the Viper, then Rabbit shows up and two-shots him.
Yeah.
Which is still in favor of Titan, don't get me wrong, but not as nice.
Might see a Desperation Smoke Gang coming out here. Or just Titan lining up behind the Tinker. Still no Ethereal Blade on him.
Cubed. A lot of harm.
Yeah, 40 minutes into the game and Tinker still doesn't have anything to really show for it.
Tinker just hasn't had that much of an impact, to be honest. Like, here and there he's made some plays, but for the most part it's been rocket spam and lasers, and that's okay. Like, that's what you expected of a Tinker. Big plays from a Tinker tend to be just isolating targets, coming in from weird angles, and always being there in the nick of time. And I just
he's
really
not necessarily always a great pick. You need to have a lineup that can sort of back him up and
right.
provide that gank ability for him and create that snowball effect where he really, really shines. And this lineup has just proven not to be it, not against this LGD lineup at least.
Still scrapping it out though. Yeah, taking some ancients while they're about it. Roshan is back up in mere seconds, and it looks like, yep, they're going to keep checking it. Coming up in 40. So, holding on for it while they can. Yamate has an invis. No one going to be getting near him to give him the chance to use it though.
There we go. 3,300 gold on the Tinker, so that Eagle Song can finally be picked up.
I mean, looking through, like, we could talk about IM choices and decisions and all this, but really, it's just on Titan to really execute. Like, the game has reached the point it has that it's going to revolve around a Roshan. It's going to be LGD, who has the Rosh advantage, being on the dire side, continually checking it with that Shadow Poison, knowing it's just about that time. And yeah, there he is. So next time they check, they'll find the big boys home.
Just not sure there's anything they can do with the heroes they have right now. Even the DeLorean, who was saying he picked up a Blacking Bar now, he's sitting on an additional 1500 gold. Lifesteal, of course, already hard enough to deal with as it is. And then Lin, out of inside, closing in on his Scepter.
Dire's top tower is under
Roche,
attack.
Down to half health already. That medallion picked up very early by the Shadow Demon. And yeah, they got a chance here. They better get in there quick. Titan better go right now. If he does, there it is. Ravage in the pick. Can they bring him down? DD's in trouble outside of it. But Roche goes down and it's Lifestealer gets the Aegis anyway. Cheese is still on the ground. Didn't see who grabbed that. Was it Lin? Yes, Lin has the Cheese. Now Ohio, being pursued out. DD back up off of the reincarnation. He basically just ran interference. Yao helping to chase them out. They finish off the Tidehunter elsewhere. And they're going to be able to get the brew as well. DDC right there. Actually, he's able to blink and didn't quite make it. And Yao makes it a triple kill as they pursued all the way to mid to clean up the rest. And down goes the brew elsewhere.
Yeah, and Yao just showed how good his invoker really is. He just blinked in the fray of things, let off a full combo, and killed both the Tinker and the AA almost immediately. And they're just going to head for the middle lane now. There's no tower to take down before going for the Rexus. And because the creeps are in on the bottom lane, they can actually just go straight in and ignore it without... Well, the creep wave is coming behind them now, but...
Pretty sure this is gonna be your GG.
You probably expect a GG call, especially when Titan respawns, goes out and tries to fight again, and... Will fall short. Abyssal Blades, of course, up on the Lifestealer.
Well, there's no ultimate dependent, and their ultimates have basically been used to kill one hero and one hero only. And yeah, Lin just really has not cared. 4 and 5, that's fine by him. Just look at his team. Look how big Rabbit got in the meantime as they clear out two sets of racks. And a little surprised that Titan's actually still hanging in this. Like, they're so far behind, and Tinker's a good hero, I know, but he ain't that good.
Yeah, and so what LGD just needs to do now, if not going for the throne, is just pushing out that top lane.
Yep.
They might re-engage from the bottom lane.
Wait on reincarnate, another 60 seconds for that. Would make sense to me. No, it doesn't look like they want to. They lock and load. They've got the Lifestealer inside.
There we go.
Yep, BKB, jump in, there's the infest out, and Yamate brought down before he could even split. And he does not have buyback. LGD takes the kill, and I thought they were gonna go throne, but looks like they're more interested in doing this methodically. So go grab the creep wave and bring down the tier 2 top.
And if there's one word that describes LGD, or at least the LGD of old, it's definitely methodically. Mm-hmm. That is how they've always been playing. Very controlled, never rushing anything.
Here we go. Collapsing now, and what could be the final push of the game. There's really no reason to back off, especially now that they have their ultimates back up. Yao has really turned it on later in this game, Scythe of Ice, and his play in general. And then a huge impetus. Pipe's gonna be used, they're gonna go ahead and rush up. And using Necro Creeps to screen a little bit. Ohio hanging out on the side, he's got his Ravage ready. They take the tier 3 and decide to go ahead and pull back. And a little curious about that. Yeah, they're just going all the way back home.
Maybe they enjoy playing this game so much. Desolator now up on DD.
Well, LGD putting the finishing touches on this one is Titan. I mean, there's really no other way to put it. They've, like, Titan has hung around and made a game of this, but for the most part, LGD has been in the driver's seat for, I would say, of this 43-minute game, probably 30-plus minutes.
Oh, definitely. And just looking at the inventories on the LGD lineup, every one of them is so fully stacked. 6k gold up on Yao, only has one inventory slot left. Rabbit, of course, sitting with the Aegis, just completed a full assault career off the courier as well. And then the four-position DD coming in with the Desolator and the Black King Bar.
Well, we've got the Tidehunter hanging out. Ohio has been sitting in this one spot for quite some time now, hoping to catch them with their pants down. And hit a big Ravage. Maybe he's got a gem that tracks four-man Ravages. DD, once again, carrying his passenger. And this is that methodical style. Once again, LGD, even with this big of a lead, even when it looks this foolproof, is going to take their time to do it the way they think.
Yamate just blew up on the bottom lane.
Didn't even see it. I was watching for the Tide Ravage, actually.
I think that was two or three hits on the Brewmaster.
They're watching for the Tide Ravage, Ohio. Just gonna let his racks die. Alright, cool. Not gonna worry about it. Got it. And we're gonna see KYXY found out there. And DD and Lin continuing to just dive further back. And the buyback on the Tinker immediately. There's GG. So, Ravage finally comes out. Go get DD and do a little damage out of it, but GG's already been called, and Titan ends up dropping this game. And dropping a little lower in the standings. That's going to put them at 7-6, but guess what? LGD, the comeback is real. That moves them to 6-7, moves them out of the bottom six, at least for now, and puts them in the range of the likes of Fnatic, Team Liquid, and the rest. I'm actually going to refresh the standings.